everyone. We just came back from Mississippi. If you saw our last couple of videos, you know that on the first day it was really cold, and by the second and third day we had a huge temperature shift, and by the last day the temperature dropped again. So I'm going to walk you through some of the stuff that I wore from Prois on the first day when it was really cold, and then how I changed my layering over the next couple of days as the temperature continued to change. Layer, I wore the down jacket. It has two pockets on the outside and two pockets on the inside as well, and I'm going to show you how that fits. This jacket is filled with 800 power fill gray goose down, and it's extremely light and extremely packable. I'm going to put the specs in the description below, as well as how much each of these items weighs. So, my favorite part about this jacket, I got the extra small so that it fit pretty compactly. That way I could wear it underneath some of my larger layers. So that might be something to think about when you're purchasing all of your layers. And I'll tell you how I sized up in some of these items as well, so that I can wear them over some of my other layers. So this jacket is made of 100% polyester ripstop, which makes it incredibly soft and incredibly durable in the woods as well. I'm going to show you some of the pieces that I wore in Mississippi again. These are the pieces I wore over the top of my base layers and my mid layers to keep me really, really warm on that first day when it was really, really cold. So some of the features about this jacket that I love. This jacket is brand new, and on the back of the hood you have this adjustable strap, which can make the hood really, really tight, or as tight as you want it around the face, and that keeps it really, really wind resistant. Then also on the back, I never ever climb without my safety harness, and this jacket has a cool new feature on the back that allows you to put your safety harness underneath your jacket, wear your jacket over your safety harness, and just pop your safety harness through this new feature in the back of the jacket, and I love that. On the inside, it is also lined with this really, really soft fleece, which keeps you really warm. And on the inside, there is also one pocket as well. So I'm going to show you how this jacket fits me and some of the features when you're wearing this jacket that I love. I sized up in my jacket. I went with the size small instead of extra small. I normally get everything in extra small. I went with the small so that I knew I was going to be layering underneath this. For Mississippi, I went with the burrito jacket, then I had my down jacket over that, and that all fit like there was still more room inside of this jacket that I could have layered more if it was really, really cold. So some more features about this jacket that I like. Over the top of the zipper, also you have these buttons that you can snap closed, which keep it even more wind resistant and water resistant as well. And when you zip it all the way up, you're going to get complete coverage. This jacket has adjustable wrist straps, and it's made of 100 grams per square meter of Primaloft Next and 133 grams per square meter of Primaloft Cold. The last item that I wore for the Mississippi trip is the new bib from Prois. This has a zipper in the front and a zipper side pocket on the thigh, just like the tin tree pants. Something else I like about this is the zipper on the side pants. You are able to zip this right over the top of your boots, and it's perfect. It's just the right length. This is the size extra small. I did not size up in this, and it comes just to the bottom, the top of my boots, just above the floor, and I think that's a great length. So this bib is made of fleece, and it is made of the same amount of Primaloft Next and Primaloft Gold as the Greann jacket. I did find that on the first day when the temps were down in the 30s, that when I wore my bib, my down jacket for the mid layer, and my big jacket over the top, that that was perfect. It could have been 0 degrees and I still would have been warm in that combo, but as the day went on and it got to the middle of the day, I did strip off my big jacket and my down, like I said, and I just scouted in my merino, and that was about 70 degrees, 65, 70 degrees, and that merino really kept me warm as we were active through the middle of the day. By the second day, when the temperatures in the morning were already hitting 60 degrees as the sun was coming up, I found that just wearing my bib with my down jacket and no longer wearing my big jacket was perfect as well, as it got to be about 60 degrees, 65 degrees sitting in the stand in the morning. And by the third day, I found that just wearing my tin tree pants and my down jacket when it got to be about 70, 75 degrees in the Mississippi air, that was perfect as well. And here in Florida, I found that hunting in my down jacket in the morning is great. And then in the afternoons, I'll usually just wear my merino jacket over the top of my Solus ultra lightweight shirt. And that's perfect for the cooler temps in the late season here in Florida. Hopefully you guys found this helpful to see how I layer for the colder temperatures, and also some of my favorite pieces for hunting here in Florida that are ultra lightweight and sun protectant. I'm going to put all the specs and descriptions for these items and the link to Prois down below. If you have any questions or comments about some of the pieces that I showed you today or sizes, please feel free to comment down below. If you like this and you want to see more reviews on some of the camouflage that I wear in the woods, please like, subscribe. See you guys next time.